And now, here we are with one of the stars, I guess, of Editfest. It's Norman Hollyn.
I love how you say that.
I mean it.
Say that again.
I saw you last year, too, and I said...
Thank you.
Last year, you talked about tweeting and the number of followers you had. I think it was 75. How much has it increased?
It is. I'm like 2,500, 2,400 followers now.
Oh, my God. You're a star. I can't tweet. I don't even have a cell phone. I'm really old school.
So important.
I know. You
it's
said
so
that.
Important that, like, you get to know the people who you affect, and they give feedback to you. That's really so much of what this is about. It's an important tool. Well, listen. More than half of what we do as editors is not about the editing. It's about convincing people that you have their back, that you're working from the same, that you want them to succeed. You want the film to succeed. So what it's about is really reaching out and expanding your circle of people who will trust you and who know you've got their back. Twitter is just one of the ways to do that. I've met so many people on Twitter who I've developed good friendships with as a result. So.
Another way to do that is to read your new book, which is called
The Lean Forward Moment.
The Lean Forward Moment. I love that. That's a good
Well,
title.
Thank you. Yes.
And that was the name of the panel tonight.
That was.
I leaned forward to find out.
Well, you know, one of the reasons why I called it The Lean Forward Moment is because people sort of understand that right away. You go, how do I involve an audience in what I'm doing? How do you get them to emotionally lean forward and pay attention to what I'm telling them in this scene, in this shot, in this film? So when you say lean forward moment, they go, I understand what you're talking about. You're talking audience involvement.
Well, I'm a theater critic and a film critic, so I know when I find myself in that lean forward position, it's good. They've involved me. I'm like on the edge of my seat, as
right.
it were.
It's about... It's about storytelling to the audience. I'm not a big fan of creating movies just for me. There's no way I didn't get into this business to affect just me. I got into it to affect people who are watching what I do as an editor, as a writer, whatever. I want to affect people. So that requires that I understand what affects people, what moves people, what gets them to go, oh, lean forward. Ah, I see what you're trying to tell me. So theater, same thing.
And the book is Lean Forward Moment by
Norman Hollyn.
You were a New Yorker, but now you're in LA, you're in Hollywood.
I'm bi-coastal. That's how I look at it. I'm bi, right? So I got my start in the film business here in New York. I worked with some absolutely amazing editors, some amazing directors. And then I needed to, I reached a point where I needed to take the next step in terms of who I was working with as an editor, and that wasn't happening in New York. So I moved to LA and got a chance to work with some other amazing people to expand that circle. So I like both. Now, I'm here in New York now. It's amazing.
I don't drive. I'm stuck here being a New York star, but whatever.
You could do worse, right?
I could do worse. Well, my cameraman and editor, Kevin Teller, is a very shy guy, and he was telling me he has to get over that to be an editor.
You do.
Does he have to? Get a chair.
That's right. Come on, Sabine.
Sabine, here.
Yes.
Sit over here, darling.
Yeah, listen, the days when we could just...
We just both saw a beautiful blonde woman, and we have to bring her in.
This is where you get
I'm gay, so it does nothing
awesome
for me.
On my panel tonight. Thank you.
Wasn't she amazing?
She was. She was. I want to take her home with me to L.A., right?
And that perfume, darling, what are you wearing?
I'm not telling.
Oh, you're not going to tell us. Oh, okay. All right, that's just...
off the subject.
That's just Sabine, yes.
It's all editing.
It's all editing. It's about editing. Okay, she's editing me right now. No, I love Rebecca Miller's films. I'm a big, big fan. Personal Velocity was one of my 10 best that year. And you were the editor.
I feel very fortunate to have met Rebecca and very honored to be working with her.
What's she like?
She's an amazing filmmaker and an amazing person. Very inspiring, always searching, and it's just a pure joy to work with her.
I think about Personal Velocity a lot, that movie, and how well it was done, and you're one of the reasons.
That's very flattering, but
no. It was three stories, right?
It was, and it was based on her book. And that's a lot of her projects start in some other form.
It was based on what?
It was based on her book of short
stories. Oh, okay.
Yeah. And one of the things that she points out is the freedom for her to make her films the way she does is that sometimes if they already exist, the stories already exist in another form. For example, Personal Velocity was already the short stories, two of them. That it gives her the freedom to be less precious about the film material, because it is a different medium, and she very carefully says, okay, this is a novel, this is the film. So there's different ways of approaching
it. So that really is smart, yes.
She must be like your best friend at this point, or one of them.
She's never precious about material, and she's always pushing it to be the best it can be, and really questioning what can we do. So in Personal Velocity, one of the things we explored a lot was the voiceover, obviously. And to the point
we talked about in the panel tonight, wasn't that like you can't fall in love with your own ideas. You have to always be willing to kill your babies, to give them up, to say there's a higher purpose here, which is the ultimate story for my audience. So that's amazing that she can do that.
Well, I in terms of the Stephen Holt show, I always tell people the reason I've been on for 23 years is the guests. I give it, you give it all to the guests, you give them the best shot, you listen to them, and then you shut up and just listen to you two brilliant people. I'm like, overwhelmed. Thank you.
Well, that's
but
actually...
You have a way of getting it out of everybody, right? You have a way of combining the energies and kind of playing the ball.
He's a very good host. I'm a host, so I can say that.
You see me working, right?
Yeah, I'm taking notes.
But that part of this is getting great people up there and just having this little cocktail party conversation where we say amazing things when we're away from the camera, away from audiences, when we're just sitting there talking about what we do, right? So how can we capture and share that, right?
Right. I was saying to Anne and some other panelists, it would be so lovely if we could have mini forums more often, because I really love the exchange.
Well, it's Editfest. Let's say to our viewers who've just turned in, we're talking about Editfest and why we love it. And I'm sitting here with two of the stars. Editors to me are stars. I'm sorry, they just are. And you film geeks, you gotta know this. You gotta know who these
I
people
love
are.
Love this guy.
And it's Sabine. What is your last name? Now I'm gonna.
It's Sabine Hoffman.
Sabine Hoffman, right? And Norm Hollyn. And I. One of the purposes of EditFest is to raise the profile of great editors like you both are,
yes.
So that people will know just, you know, what you do and how important it is.
There's such an amazing contribution that people like to be bringing to the collaboration.
She's pushing me off the chair!
Come on over here now.
Okay. Yes, not his. No,
I've never been pushed off.
Pushed off a chair by a woman before. That's a new. I kind of like it. No, it's lovely.
This is not just a woman. This is an editor.
Oh, it's an editor. Yes. No, you're a star, darling. You're a star. Today on the Stephen Holt Show, you're stars. But I just think EditFest is wonderful in that it's getting. You're trying to raise the profile of editors.
And part
Don't
of what is...
Look at the camera sometimes, darling, because you're so beautiful. Oh God, Norm knows how
there.
To do that.
There's a camera there.
There's
oh
a camera
God.
There, yeah.
It's really wonderful to be a part of a community that is a community of your peers in a way that everybody understands what we're going through. And ACE has been an amazing organization.
And ACE is, what
together.
Is that?
The American Cinema Editors.
Now, are they involved with the Academy Awards, which I do
no,
a lot with?
No, that's a different organization, which is it's called AMPAS, which is the Association of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. And there is an editing branch in that. But this group is just editors. That's it. ACE is just a bunch of editors who love what we're doing.
But the editing branch, I have to say, because I write for Awards Daily, you know, for Sasha Stone, and we do the Oscars all year long, and one of the things she discovered was that if you're not nominated for Best Editing, you're not going to win Best Picture, and usually
that's usually true.
And the person who wins best film editing is also going to win best picture.
Can I say that this goes to what you just said about raising the concept of editing? Because most people, when they, and this is true in the Academy also, which are filmmakers, they look at a film and they go, oh, I like that film, so it was edited well. But yet there is something different about editing for a film and just best picture. But a lot of people don't understand that.
But the editing branch is all members of ACE, I think.
No, not necessarily.
No,
not necessarily.
No, this is new. Sasha, listen to this.
There is a lot of overlap, but that there are lots of editors who are in one but not the other.
Come closer.
All right, this is like a foreign movie. What country are you from, Sabine? Are you French?
No, German. Initially.
German, oh!
I'm actually American now.
Das glaube ich nicht.
That's right. Right. So what I was saying is that there are a lot of television editors in ACE who do amazing work constantly on television shows,
episodically,
and they're not nominated for Oscars because that's features only. So there's...
However, ACE is now working very actively on trying to get more recognition to editors, and
well, that's great. Like we're doing now on this
Stephen
Hope
show.
That's why you're here, right? Thank you.
Yes,
we appreciate that.
I think it's fascinating. Yeah. I think you're both fascinating. What you do is fascinating because you work with fascinating people. I'm fascinated.
We're lucky. It's really about the synergy of working.
Rebecca
with
Miller,
people.
I have to say, is one of the great filmmakers alive in America today.
Absolutely.
And I can't wait for her next movie.
One of the reasons why she's so respected and so well is because
Sabine.
Of the editor.
Yeah.
So and not to toot your horn too much. But.
Well, that's what Editfest is to bring, you know, shy editors
and horns. Right. I love it.
Thelma Schoonmaker, I said to her last year, and she sent me, this is an incredible story, she sent me, I said, you've got more Oscars. You won more Oscars than any other editor. She said, oh, no. She's so self-effacing.
Yes, she is.
And I'm not, no, it's not me. So she sent me, she typed up this detailed list of all the people who ever won more, the editors who had ever won more than one Oscar. She'd won three, but somebody else had won three in the 30s. And I got that.
Oh,
but she hadn't won the most, but she will eventually.
But can I say, as whenever you talk to Thelma, she says, Marty, it's like all Marty, it's Marty.
Yes.
When you talk to Marty about it, he's all about Thelma. He's like, Thelma's like, she shapes this, she does this. So they know. They work together really well.
Have you met Thelma?
I have met her once, and I'm in total awe of her craft.
I mean, every time Marty should have won an Oscar, she did.
Well, you know, I can't apologize for the Academy.
Well, a movie that I just saw the scene five times, I loved it so much, and I just had to bring it up because you're both here, and I thought, why not? Woody Allen's Midnight in Paris. Have you seen it?
Oh,
that we all love it. Okay,
that's
so
right.
Now you have to see it.
That's right.
I can cut you to a clip.
Go see that damn film.
I've seen it five times. That's why the box office is going
So but you're the one.
Yes, and Woody, you had one of Woody's editors here last year on your panel.
Sandy Morris. Yes, that's
original,
right.
Editor
one of the, years. Well, Ralph Rosenblum before that, and Sandy.
She was so interesting, too.
Well, yeah, they are all so interesting. In the secret dark of night, when we get together, we're all interesting people.
You
but
are.
But part of our job is to step back and let the film be in the front. So that's part of our job.
I mean, it's... And Woody works all the time now, and I'm going to forget the woman's name. There's a one...
Alyssa Elspeth. Yes.
Say that again?
Well, Alyssa. I'm not going to try and pronounce
her last name. And I thought, now he's in France, and so it's all different, and, you know...
He's been editing with Alyssa for a while.
With the same editor, so that wasn't changed. But all the other technicians, I think, were different.
That's
and,
true. Probably true,
He's going to make more money on that film than he's ever made on any other film he's ever made.
It's a phenomenal story. It's very well told. It's very involving. It has great characters. You'd have to be an idiot not to like that movie, right?
And in the end, you have to fall in love with a blonde lady from another country.
In time.
Yeah, I know. Well, listen, I could talk to you both and do specials on both of you, but
some other day, right?
Some other day. Keep in touch. I've got your emails and everything.
Yes,
and
thank you very much.
I want to sign copy and tell Rebecca how much I love her and. how many times I've talked about her movies on my show. You know,
I try. I try.
Yes. Oh, really? Is it coming up? Can you talk
about
it? No.
She's working on it.
Oh, and then you're working on it, too.
We hope so.
Oh, all right. Okay.
And thank you, Sabine.
Thank you. Norman Hollyn here today at Editfest and Sabine Hoffman. Right. The only woman who ever sat on my lap. Okay.
It's a good thing.
It's a good thing. That was great television, you guys.